Hi everyone. Today we'll introduce our topic in a different way. Okay. I have a glass of water with me and a screw. And the screw is made up of iron. Okay. Now I'm going to drop this inside this water. Okay, you saw what happened, no? Okay. Now I have another material. This is a lightweight thing. And it is made up of some cork item. Okay. Same way I'm going to drop this. Okay. So there are two things inside this water. The screw sank inside the water and the other one cork is floating. Right? So today's topic is sinking and floating. Now, what is the reason this screw sank inside the water? We studied, the chapter is dealing with the density, right? Okay, so we can define or we can give explanation in terms of density. The screw sank inside the water. The reason is that the density of the screw, that is, it's made up of iron, it is greater than the water's density. Okay. So, if we compare the density of water, what is the density of water in gram? It is 1 gram per centimeter cube, right? And the density of iron is 7.53 gram per centimeter cube. Compare this. Which one is? This is iron and this is water. Which one is having greater density? Iron is having greater density. That's why it sank inside the water. Now you see the cork, it is floating on the water. What does it mean? It means that the density of the cork is less than the density of water. Okay, the density of the cork is less than the density of water. And if you see the density of the cork, it may be 0.534 gram per centimeter cube. Okay, so if we compare the density of cork and the water, it is less than the density of water. So, we can conclude that if the material has less denser than the liquid, it can be water or any liquid. Okay. If the density of the material is less than that liquid, the material will float. Or if the density of the material is greater than the liquid, it will sink inside the liquid or inside the water. So, we can define, or that is the reason some material will float and some material will sink. The material which doesn't have or less than the density of the water or the liquid, that will float. And the materials which has more denser or more density than the particular liquid will sink inside the liquid or even the water. Now we'll see the principle of flotation. Okay. So, principle of flotation means when we consider the body which is immersed inside a liquid, we need to consider two points. First one, the weight of the body. Okay. The weight of the body is always acting vertically downward direction. What is the definition of weight? It is a gravitational pull acting on a body having a mass. Right? No, it is a gravitational attractive force by earth towards its center, or it's always directed towards downward, right? So that is called weight of the body, and it's always acting vertically downward. So this vertically downward acting force has a tendency to sink inside the water. Okay, so weight of the body is always acting vertically downward. Second one, okay. Now we just consider, I have kept this pen on my hand. Why it is not falling down? We know that the weight of the pen is always acting downward direction. At the same time, my hand is applying an opposite force on this pen. Right? No? Same way, when we keep an object inside any liquid, the weight of the body is acting downward direction. Same way, the liquid is acting an upward force. Okay. The liquid is acting another force on this body and we used to mention it as FB. Okay, we used to mention it as FB. It is known as buoyant force. Buoyant force. Or we used to call it as upthrust. Another name is upthrust. Okay, so upthrust is the force acting by the liquid on the body. When a body is kept inside the liquid or when the body is dropped inside the liquid, the weight of the body is acting downward direction. At the same time, another force, that means the liquid is also acting a force on the body in the upward direction. Weight is acting downward direction, upthrust or buoyant force is acting on the upward direction. So that is, if these two points are there, we used to call it as principle of flotation. Weight, it has a tendency to sink the object, but upthrust, it will make the object float. It will not allow the object to sink. Not all the cases, there are some conditions that we will see right now. And this buoyant force is always equal to the weight of the immersed liquid or displaced liquid inside the body. I'll show how it is. Just consider, till here, this is the initial level of the water. Now I'm going to keep some object inside this one, and when the object is kept, it is half, little bit part is floating and some part is inside the water. So what happens, the water level slightly increase the water, this much water level increase. So the weight is always acting downward direction. We have an upthrust, right? FB, we used to mention it as FB. And the value of FB is equivalent to the weight of the water displaced. Okay, some sort of water got displaced because some of the part of object is immersed inside the liquid. So how much water or the liquid displaced, the weight of that will be equivalent to the upthrust. Okay, so buoyant force is equivalent to the weight of the displaced liquid. Okay, the buoyant force is equivalent to the weight of the displaced liquid. Now we'll see which are the conditions. So how the object, so we know that sometimes the object will sink inside the water, sometimes it will be floating, completely floating, sometimes it will be partially floating. We'll see different cases. Our first case, weight of the body is greater than this buoyant force. What happens at this time? Okay, we know that weight is acting downward direction and buoyant force is acting upward direction. So consider this example. Again, we have water and I am going to drop this screw. Okay, what happens? The entire screw would sink inside the water. So this is the example, or this is the condition, that is weight of the body is greater than the buoyant force. What is buoyant force? Buoyant force is equal to the weight of the water displaced. Only little bit water displaced, but here the buoyant force, comparing with the weight of the body, the buoyant force is less. That's why when this condition comes, when the weight is greater than the buoyant force, the body will sink inside the liquid. Okay, so this is our first condition. When weight is greater than the buoyant force, the body or object will sink inside the particular liquid. So when we see the resultant force, here what is resultant force? That means we need to consider the, just consider this as the figure. The object is inside this. Okay, so weight is acting downward direction and FB is acting upward direction. So how can we find the resultant force? Here both are force. Resultant force means W minus FB. So your weight of the body is greater than the buoyant force. So we will get a value which is in the direction of downward direction. Okay, the resultant force means we need to consider the direction also. Just consider the weight of the object is 50 newton and buoyant force is 10 newton. Total can we get 40 newton. And what is the direction? Because 50 is a greater value, we have to consider this direction. It is acting downward way. Okay. So that means the object, if the weight is greater than the buoyant force, it means that the density of the material is greater than the liquid. Now we'll see the second case here. Weight of the body is equivalent to the up thrust. So both are equal. What will happen? That we'll see with the next experiment. Okay. So again, I have a glass of water and another material. I'm going to dip with this one. Okay. Now we can see that the material is inside the water, but it is floating. The entire material is inside the water, but it is floating. So that means the weight of the body is equivalent to the buoyant force or up thrust. Okay, when the weight of the body is equivalent to the up thrust, the body will float inside the water, but the entire body will be immersed inside the water. Okay, we cannot see any portion outside the water level. The entire body will be inside the water when weight of the body is equivalent to up thrust, or else we can tell that it's floating. Okay, floating will be the condition, plus density of the material will be, density of the material will be equivalent to density of the liquid or water. First case, the density of the material is greater than the density of the liquid. Second case, it is floating but completely inside the water. That case, the density of the material is equivalent to the density of the water or density of the liquid. Here we have an example with the water. So density of this material is equivalent to the density of water. That's why the entire object is floating but completely dipped or immersed inside the liquid. A last condition, when weight of the object is less than the buoyant force. Okay, when the weight of the object is less than the buoyant force. Here we'll have another example, glass of water and another material. Okay, just see what happens. So some part is inside the water and some part is above the water. Right? No? So some part is inside the water and some part is above the water. So here also, comparing with the second case, the density of the material is comparatively less than that of the liquid or water. But little bit portion is inside the water. It means that how much buoyant force is there, there to balance. There is a weight of the body is there, right? No? So, how much is the weight of the body, that should be balanced with the buoyant force. So, to balance that buoyant force, little bit portion of the material will be inside the water. So, it finally it will float inside the water. Okay. So, here also the density of the material is less than the density of the water. And if we see second case and third case, both the cases, if we take the resultant value, okay, if you see the resultant value or apparent weight, it is zero. Apparent weight means the in effect weight. The in effect weight is zero in both the cases, because both the case the object is floating. Okay, so third case, if the weight of the body is less than the buoyant force, the body will float, only a little bit portion is inside the water. Okay, when you are drawing the picture, you have to mention the direction of weight and the direction of FP. FP is also acting here as upward direction. Okay, so here little bit portion is inside the liquid and the rest of the portion is above the liquid. So how much is the liquid displaced, so the equivalent to the balancing with the buoyant force, that much portion will be inside the liquid and that will be equivalent to the weight of the body. These are three conditions together in one frame. First one, the object sank inside the water. Second one, the object is completely inside the water but it's floating. The third one, only a little bit portion is inside the water and the rest of the portion is
above the water. In that case also it is floating.
Thank you.